It is exciting to see a new trend emerging in the Pakistani television drama industry, with major TV channels producing short series and experimenting with different genres. Recently, the crime thriller short series Jurm, directed by Mehreen Jabbar, concluded its run on JioTV. Despite its promising and gripping start, the thriller series ultimately left us feeling unsatisfied and longing for a greater level of intensity and twists, especially at the conclusion of the story. It intrigued us to explore the reasons why Pakistani drama makers often fail to provide us with gripping thrillers and how this particular genre can further push the boundaries and unlock the untapped potential of our drama industry. Frames and Beyond presents the not-so-thrilling making of crime thrillers in Pakistan. One genre that has been underrepresented on Pakistani TV screens is the crime thriller. Although crime thrillers have been explored to some extent in the past in the form of longer series, there is a lot of potential for more thrilling and engaging dramas in this genre. We need more stories that can captivate audiences with their fresh, exciting, and well-paced content, and will keep them on the edge of their seats. The recent Mehreen Jabbar directorial called Jurm gave us some hope from its start, but fell short of the same issues we have from the longer thriller series. The short series of 4 episodes revolves around Ayla and Danyal, whose newly wed bliss is shattered when they become victims of a terrifying kidnapping incident. As the investigation into the crime unfolds, we are drawn into the intricate dynamics of an affluent family and the people surrounding them. The crime scene setting reminds us of the Anni Diwani murder case from the 2010s. However, it is important to note that the story is not entirely derived from that case. Shah Yasir, the writer of the series, ventures into an experimental territory with a screenplay that employs a non-linear storytelling technique. This approach keeps us engaged and intrigued at the start, constantly guessing and piecing together the puzzle pieces until its anticlimactic end. The narrative is woven around characters who prove to be quite the enigma at the start. However, despite these compelling elements, the story falls short of delivering a satisfying and conclusive ending. Unfortunately, this is not an uncommon occurrence, as many crime thrillers in Pakistan have struggled with delivering satisfying conclusions, leaving fans of the genre feeling let down. While we do hope this trend of making short series prevails and we see more such content in the crime thriller genre, we cannot ignore certain aspects of our storytelling techniques which need revision. And this brings us to the question of what sets apart a great crime thriller and how have the whodunit stories been made into Pakistani dramas? Let's take a closer look at the current state of Pakistani thrillers and the areas where we are falling short. Unnecessary subplots and side characters. It is unfortunate that the formula for drama making in Pakistan often fails to adapt to changing genres. In an attempt to keep the family drama audience engaged with crime dramas, makers sometimes include unnecessary plot lines and side characters. However, these additions often do a disservice to the overall plot and storyline. Whether it's the inclusion of the Mamu ka beta plot in Dushmane Ja or the Bhai aur Bhabhi plot of the antagonist's friend in Dunk. It is surprising how these scenes or characters are believed to add any sort of value to the progression of the plot. What it does is make the audience lose track and interest in the progression of the original case that is the core of the plot. As drama makers venture into shorter thriller series like Ek Thi Laila and Jurm, where the focus is on a more concise screenplay, it is puzzling to observe scenes and unnecessary parallel stories that are mere distractions from the main plot. For instance, in Ek Thi Laila, we witness moments involving the daughter of Constable Rukaya and domestic abuse within her home. Similarly, in Jurm, there is a scene where the suspect's son brings home food by picking a pocket. The lingering question remains, how do these scenes contribute to the advancement of the plot? Why are we unable to bypass these plots and characters that add little value, and instead focus on adding more layers and twists to the character that truly captivate the audience's interest? Loopholes and blunders. Crime thrillers, like many other Pakistani dramas, are not exempt from encountering loopholes in the storyline, silly blunders, and notorious continuity issues. We often see actors' appearances and costumes changing between cuts of the same scene. Even in dire situations, the female lead manages to maintain a flawless manicure and impeccably blow-dried hair. In the case of Jurm, we witness a character watching a paused YouTube video on their laptop while it continues to play. These trivial details aside, it is disheartening to see certain plot lines in thriller dramas being presented as significant clues, only to be left unaddressed and unresolved in the story's conclusion. This lack of closure not only leaves the audience with unanswered questions, but also undermines the integrity of the narrative. Our makers need to understand the significance of the script supervisors and the costume department to prevent such mishaps. This compromises the overall production quality of the project, despite the availability of sufficient budgets. Merely relying on grand or outdoor locations does not guarantee a stellar production. Drama OST and background music. In crime thrillers, the importance of a captivating background score cannot be overstated, as it serves to heighten the tension and set the desired atmosphere for each scene. However, in Pakistani dramas, this crucial aspect is often overlooked, resulting in a failure to engage and captivate the audience. Inappropriate background music or excessive use of sound effects detracts from the impact of the scene. Our makers tend to rely on OSTs as a one-size-fits-all solution for all kinds of emotions and scenes, which proves to be a grave mistake. For instance, the song Tere Bin playing in the background during the arrest of Mahira Khan's character in Hum Kahan Ke Sachche The, or the overly dramatic O Saiya Ve during Sana Javed's character arrest in Dunk. Furthermore, sometimes the selected OST does not align with the theme of the drama, as seen in the case of the upbeat romantic song Ye Dil Mera used in a murder mystery and a revenge story. This disregard for the importance of suitable and effective background music diminishes the potential impact of the drama on the audience. In Ek Thi Laila, we witnessed a commendable use of background music during a thrilling chase sequence. The retro crime drama inspired score created the perfect mood for the scene, incorporating elements of urgency and even comedy. This clever choice of background music aligned seamlessly with the overall theme of the drama, enhancing the viewing experience for the audience. Cliche, illogical clues, and plot devices. The crime mystery drama loses this impact when illogical and cliched plot points are used to unveil the evidence leading to the real criminal during the investigation. These situations often seem contrived and uninspired, resulting from a lack of attention to detail or unrefined writing. For instance, in Jurm, why would a police officer report the progress of the case and the discovered evidence to the victim's father-in-law, who could also be a suspect? Additionally, the notion of finding fingerprints on the shell of a bullet seems highly improbable and unrealistic. In one of the most absurd scenes from Ye Dil Mera, we witnessed Ahad Raza Mir's character using an array of mobile phones and random scripts running on his laptop to make an untraceable call to his arch enemy. Talk about overcomplicating things. It's hard to take these scenes seriously when it's filled with such implausible plot devices. This kind of careless storytelling not only undermines the character's credibility, but also highlights the lack of creative and realistic writing in the drama. Editing and screenplay. Editing plays a significant role in maintaining the pacing and rhythm of the story, especially in a crime thriller. Through precise cuts, transitions, and sequencing of shots, the editor can control the flow of information, strategically revealing clues and unraveling the mystery bit by bit. The role of editors in shaping a crime thriller cannot be underestimated. They possess the power to either enhance or undermine the story's impact. In the case of Jurm, we observed some confusing choices in the editing. There were slow motion shots during the police chase that added neither value nor a hint of suspense, followed by an anticlimactic end that left us scratching our heads. Moreover, the sudden transitions between scenes disrupted the overall flow and coherence, making it difficult to grasp the context and shifting moods. The attempt at non-linear storytelling is commendable, but unfortunately, it resulted in confusion rather than intrigue because of the editing choices. As the narrative and timelines jumped back and forth, we found ourselves struggling to understand the present events and their connection to the past. The application of a hazy sepia tone filter in flashback scenes, though intended to differentiate timelines, only added to the confusion, especially when multiple timelines were interwoven. Underwhelming endings. Crime dramas rely heavily on the element of surprise and the ability of the writer to catch the audience off guard with a clever twist on an unexpected ending. However, in Pakistani thriller dramas, the plots often lack creativity and are disappointingly predictable. In Ek Thi Laila, the narrative took an inexplicable turn in the end, shifting from a girl leading men on to a misunderstood victim who eventually runs off with another man. The audience is left feeling confused and cheated by the unsatisfactory conclusion. In the case of Jurm, all the suspense and anticipation built throughout the series is ultimately squandered as the first suspect is unveiled as the actual murderer. Their motive for financial gain is further compromised by the careless act of leaving a valuable bracelet behind in the victim's car. It is disheartening to witness such lackluster and unimaginative writing as quality entertainment. As viewers, we eagerly anticipate the evolution of crime thriller dramas, the emergence of fresh narratives, and the innovative approaches that push the boundaries of the genre. Let us know in the comments below some of the other common aspects in our crime thriller Pakistani dramas that we might have missed. We would love to read them. And while you are doing that, please don't forget to like and share this video and subscribe to our channel Frames and Beyond for more interesting content.